You know, I was just approached 2 seconds ago, and someone told me to have a good day. It's 5:30 in the morning, my normal time to get down to this gym. Now, I usually stay here an hour and a half. I only come now 6 days a week, because the seventh day belongs to my father. And I don't exercise my body, but my mind is continuously in exercise. But the person asked me to have a good day. You know, and it felt good that they would ask me that. You know, it's how a person presents themselves and how a person is carried by God. Most people say that they carry themselves, but you cannot carry yourself. God carries you. But I understand when I say it's how a person carries themselves. That's just how I want to present it to you, because that's how we talk. But it's how God carries you. Because when people can recognize the God in you, they can respect you as you are being carried by God, as you carry yourself. And it's a great feeling, you know, when somebody can tell you, have a good morning. I mean, I was just going to the water fountain to get a sip of water out in the hallway. We got 2 water fountains, one for big people and one for little kids. And they just approached me, have a good day. And I want them to have a blessed day too. But I say that to say this, my brothers and my sisters. You know how I talk, because the forces are invisible that are forcing us by enforcing us to do the things that we do that we don't want to do. And there are many of us that are enforced by the forces, as if they had a hand pushing us forward, forcing us to do the things we don't want to do. Many of us, we don't want to die of cancer, and we know that cigarettes is a possibility that can help us to die of cancer. I'm not saying that it will, but I'm saying it's a possibility. And we know cigarettes are not good for our health, but we continue to smoke the cigarettes. For what reason? I assume that it relaxes the individual. This is my assumption, you see, but that's a vice. And there's a small inner person within you that tells you every time you light that cigarette that you should put it down, and you should put it out. Now, you need to live for yourself in order to live for your children. You need to live for yourself. And one less cigarette may mean another 6 months for you. I'm just explaining this as a scenario, but I'm not speaking on the cigarette. I'm speaking on the force behind the cigarette, which is demonic. These are deceptive forces of evil. These are satanic forces, deceptive forces of evil that are there. You can't see them, but now I'm showing you them, and you can see them. They're there, deceptive forces. Satan, as I said, is the puppet master. Periodically, I bring that particular insight to mind. And can you imagine that he has, the puppet's master has puppeteers, and I bring that to you. And there you are dangling on them strings, and they get that cigarette and put it in your mouth. I bring these scenarios to you because you need to see them. There you are, tying up your arm, shooting at drugs within your arm. There you are, lighting up that pipe of crack. There you are. There you are, drinking yourself to oblivion. There you are, my brothers and my sisters. And I'm not saying that. I'm saying this through the Spirit of God that is within me. But I am not saying that, because if I was to say that, then you will say, because you see my physical flesh, who does he think he is telling us that we can't do this or we shouldn't do this. I'm saying this through the Spirit of God. As I told you, I'm allowing you to look at the invisible man, the forces behind what you do, the forces behind what we do. There are forces behind what we do. We don't do what we do many of times because we want to do it. We do what we do because of the forces behind what we do that's forcing us to do what we do, my brothers and my sisters. For there are many times that we don't want to just go in circles. You know, you're doing the same thing every day and getting the same results. Same thing every day and getting the same results. But you don't like the results that you're getting, but you continue to do the same thing every day and get the same results. And it's time to do something different, that you get a different result. You can't keep going around in circles. You got to break that circle, my brothers and my sisters. It's like when I get on the treadmill every morning. I get on that treadmill. I'm running in time, but I'm going nowhere. I'm running in time, but I'm going nowhere. You understand what I'm saying? I'm going nowhere, but I'm running in time. In your life, time is passing you by, but you're going nowhere. Time is passing you by, but you're going nowhere. And it's so beautiful, my brothers and my sisters, but the vices are there. And when someone gives good advice, you rather take the bad advice and you continue to keep yourself in a vice. So I'm speaking to your heart, speaking to your heart, to your mind, to your soul. I'm speaking from the Spirit of God, my brothers and my sisters. I'm speaking to the Spirit within you, my brothers and my sisters. These forces are out there. These forces are in here, in this room, at this very moment. And they are so-called invisible. But if you have insight and don't look to just plain sight, then you may be able to see them. You may be able to see them when you raise your voice at your children for no reason. You may be able to see them when you curse at somebody for no reason. You may be able to see them, my brothers and my sisters, when you walk around in anger all day. Why should you always have a rain cloud over your head? Why should you always have thunder and lightning in your mind space, my brothers and my sisters? I come to you because I care about you. Now I have to go to exercise. I have to finish doing my routine, get my act together. But these are just a few words of insight from a man that used to look with just plain sight. But I had to begin to look into things to find out why things weren't working. When I began to look into things and find out why things weren't working, then I began to find out how to make things work. When I began to find out how to make things work, I got off of running around in circles. I got off that treadmill where I was running in time but going nowhere. And I began to make time work for me instead of me working for time. Our Father is a loving Father, and He wants to have a relationship with you. He wants to have a relationship with you. He wants to talk to you. And He wants to talk with you. He doesn't just want you talking at Him. You need to take time to yield what I'm saying and hear these videos. Play them. Play them for your friends. Play them for yourself. Take care of your children. Do not allow the weeds to choke out the seeds that you have planted by allowing them to see you always smoking a cigarette, always yelling and screaming, always doing drugs. Because what you give them, they may give you back in your grandchildren. What you give them, they may give you back in your grandchildren. And when you begin to look at a reflection of yourself in your own seed, don't be surprised with what you see. When you begin to look at them and see a reflection of yourself in your own seeds, don't be surprised with what you see. Sure, you got them through high school and you got them through college. Now you have to bring them to God if they have never been. And if they had been, bring them back to God, that they shall be with God in the end. But we are living in the end times, my brothers and my sisters, and times will become very critical. There will be a lot of dark days upon this earth. And there will be a lot of people that always thought about just receiving things when they are not able to get them things. Are going to have a very troubled mind. It's something that no one can take from you is the Spirit of God. If you have the Spirit of God within you, then you'll be able to persevere, my brothers and my sisters. You'll be able to take yourself where you need to be in the Spirit of God. And all these things, that's all they are things, will be meaningless. Don't get caught up in things. Get caught up in God. I can stand here and I can talk to you for hours, planting seeds within the makeup of your mind. But I don't know if the seeds that I'm planting in the makeup of your mind will help to make up your mind, because if they will have growth. For in 10 minutes, anyone can come along and be as the weed and hand you some drugs and you start smoking that. And the next thing you know, the seed never gets a chance to grow to a flower, but the weeds are there to choke it out. Think about what I'm saying. Think about what I'm saying. Care for your garden. Take care of your children. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.